Welcome to the Lotus Houses tutorial. In this episode, we want to apply a texture on the mesh we created in the last episode. My mainly procedure is that I applied texture on the meshes I create in the same way I created the meshes. So we start with the facade and the roof, then the rain gutter and then the other stuff. As you should know from the tutorials about 3ds Max, when you want to apply a texture, you go to the material editor, then choose a bitmap. In fact, we don't want the texture applied on all meshes, so we select the one we want the texture on. As you can see here in Google Earth, we have to make a small adjustment because the windows aren't the same width. This should be, we should translate them a little bit more like this and have to look for the outcome. One thing you should look for are the edges of this texture. So if there's a edge where the other side of the texture has another color, you should move the UVW points a bit up or a bit away from the edge. In this case, it's 0.002 that avoids some maybe bad looking small edges. So basically we again select this and flip this because it's obviously wrong, and to do so we flip horizontal and have our result. And this is the main thing we do with the other polygons too. Thank you. So to explain a bit, we just got textured nearly all of the facade. And as you can see here, there is an error with the mapping because it's upside down. Basically you have to flip it vertical to get it in the right position. The next thing is the door, and it is a little bit special, as you can clearly expect from this weird looking mesh. Easy thing about it is the door itself. So if you have something special like this and you've selected the box mesh, I really recommend you to use the scale function in the unwrap editor, because if you move the UVW points a bit, you kill the exact ratio between these points. And now I'm very curious what it looks like when we render the screenshot. I guess it's okay. A thing you are looking for in this render screenshot is maybe there are only triangles with one pixel mapping, so that the UVW points are located very bad and there the one pixel mapping triangles will be created. If you see something like this, you have to move the UVW points a bit so it looks smooth and clean. But in this case, we got lucky basically, so we have to adjust it afterward. So let's move on to the frame. Thank you. So the purpose on this is to get the stones in a horizontal way, because stones won't be diagonal or something like that. It appears that the stones may fit on the outside, but it's acceptable. So the store frame was hell. Now we get to the easy part, like the wall to the side. I simply use one texture. So also it's very easy to set the mapping, because you select box, and in this case you set 1.5 to the V tile. As I said, this was easy. So one step is to adjust this, because it's left over from the facade texturing, but as we see here, it should be easy. Also, a thing is, you don't have to focus on the backside of the building, because you won't see it. Let's move on to the roof. That's the last texture we load into this. Our texture we need. So we show it in viewport and apply it. And yeah, I guess it is okay. So we have to select the side. So to do so, we select the other part and invert the selection by pressing Ctrl and I. So we have the sides we want to. And this is also very easy, because you simply put this on 0.02 if the program is allowing you this. Now the upper part on the roof, it's also this texture, and am I right to just use UVWX form? And we want to, I guess we want to select the U-tile. 0.05 looks better. Now we want to also invert the selection to get the outside part, but here we want to apply a box mapping. Oh, it's special, and very special. But for this, we just want to scale it. It's also rotated by 90 degrees. One thing I want to adjust is the rain gutter, but it was a hell to texture this. So I will copy it from the German tutorial, because when I created the mesh, I also copied it. And basically, I will show you the time lapse of the mapping from the German tutorial, and well, it's about 3 minutes in time lapse or something like that. It was very hard, so I want to keep it out. What we're gonna do is we have to texture the downwards rain gutter. So let's apply a cylindrical mapping. And I'm curious what it looks like, and it's very, very special. Hell, what the font? Okay. It's not the case I was expecting, to be honest. I will have a look at the longest part and see what it looks like. It's crap, okay. Okay, as you may could see, 3ds Max calculates the exact mapping. But well, calculations sometimes fail, and I guess in 7 years of using 3ds Max, this is the worst mapping the program ever calculated. Yeah, wow, what a crap. But okay, I've got it, we've got it right, just copy it to the other side. And I also want to move it a bit to the outside, something like that. So now we want to get the rain gutter, this, select the box, now we've got it. And we use the scene material, that's a very, very important thing. Thank you. And we are done. Especially the rain gutter was a hell. We gonna check this in the render window. If we made good work. And I should rather say we did good work. It's looking great. So I'm happy about it. And now I'm done. As I said, the next episode will be about the content tool. So that's the first episode which shows Lotus internal tools. And if we get everything done about the content tool, we're gonna move on to export this house and make it work in Lotus. So I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you'll see you in the next episode. Bye.